Tomberth Harbor, home of the Jaeger fleet, is completely dependent on a single petrochemical complex for its fuel supply. The complex consists of a land-based oil refinery storage facility and an offshore oil drilling platform. Your mission is to go out and destroy, or at least damage, these sites. Our objective is to reduce production output of this complex to 20% or less. By cutting off the port's fuel supply, we will delay and disrupt the combat deployment of the Aether fleet.
Operation. Split into two groups and destroy targets. Inflict as much damage as possible to the complex and reduce their output.
There's an oil fence on the shoreline. We'll be seeing a welcoming party any minute now.
Oil rig at vector 050, 8 miles.
Halo 2, engage.
Repairing, engage.
Omega 11, engage.
Mobius 1, engage.
Damn it, he's engaging me!
Those interceptors are pesky.
I'm holding it off.
Lead them to me.
Don't fly in a straight line. What about the other target? Mobius 1, Fox 2. Mobius 1, refining facility destroyed. Switch to attacking the remaining facilities. Fox Box 2. Missile hit.
Engaging.
Picture is clear. Bandits are down or no factor. All aircraft RTB.
The enemy lost 5 million barrels of reserves and the ability to process 250,000 barrels of crude oil daily. The Aegir fleet is effectively immobilized and no longer a threat. Unfortunately, our losses were high as well. We now rely on your skills more than ever to compensate for our losses.
Freeway under construction in a wheat field outside of town. When they started construction, I remember how the mayor bragged about it, even though it would completely bypass our town. The freeway became the occupation forces' makeshift runway, and the unfinished tunnels their bunkers. This was their base. They were the elite flight squadron chosen to protect the cannon. Ironically, the same cannon that was created to shoot down the asteroids became a catalyst to the war. But when the Allied attacks no longer came, the squadron was assigned long-range missions that took them to distant battlefields. I got a knife with the intent of using it against Yellow 13. I even lifted a pistol off a drunken enemy soldier. I thought of the words I would use to confront him and bided my time. Although I harbored these feelings within me, I could never get close to him. His wingman was always by his side. Despite having a gentle demeanor, I could tell that the wingman would never allow danger to get near Yellow 13, even on land. The pillar of their group, 13 exuded an air of invincibility. He always chose to fly a five-plane formation. He was a man who prided himself not on his kill record, but on his record of never losing a squadron member. It's difficult for me to describe just how good Yellow 13's flying was, but I witnessed it once from the ground. The lead plane of the five-plane formation should have turned the same arc with the same timing as the others. Yet only his plane drew sharp contrails. His heartfelt compassion towards the weaker enemies he downed. Someday, if an equal appeared and challenged the limits of his skills in a fight, he would bear no resentment about being shot down. He said this himself. And so as time passed, I found the goodness of a home in their company. Leaving them was no longer an option for me now.